actions to take for your restoration. The first thing you are going to do is that you will begin a life of fellowship with God. A life of fellowship with God. There are people that after they have gone through bad experiences, some of them are left that even when they pray, it seems as if God does not hear them. But the best way to start off fellowship is with praise. Psalm 34 from verse 1. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my lips. The first thing to do, if you must come into your time of restoration, is you will start to live the life of praise. Bible recorded in the book of Acts, chapter 16 from verse 25. But at midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the prisoners were listening to them. May God Almighty cause you, in every prison experience that you are having now, in every situation of limitation that the enemy has ushered you into, may the Lord God Almighty restore your praise. Do you know that the moment you can praise, the moment you can begin to worship, God will take over? Verse 26, the Bible said suddenly, somebody declared suddenly, praise brings a sudden visitation. Praise opens up your heaven suddenly. There was a great earthquake so that the foundations of the prison were shaking. Your praise shakes the foundation of the prison. The praise has keys that open the prison doors. Praise has a way of bringing in special angels whose assignment is to quench the fire and the arrows of fear, doubt, unbelief, and worry. Yesterday I had a sudden message. It was an emergency call, and this man was giving up. His face had swollen, he changed, and life was leaving him. They said, they want to come. Mama, where are you? How do we bring him? And I said, they don't have to come. There is no distance in the spirit. The Holy Ghost said, open up praise immediately. Start worshiping, start praying, because the distance between their coming and their getting here, this man, you will lose him. And instantly, I was right up there. I was walking on the mountain with workers everywhere. Oh my God, that is a very precious brother. Oh my God, my heart could not bear what I heard and what I had seen. And we began to pray. I began to plead the blood. I began to worship. I began to exalt God. And then I put the word into his mouth, and then he took over. I quickly led him to Christ. And as soon as I did that, and then I began to plead the blood, and then we began to pray, and then life returned, and he was completely restored. And I just had asked him to sleep. He's going to sleep off. By the time he wakes up, he'll be old. I went to visit him very late last night when I left here. When I got, he saw me off yesterday. His family was shocked. He said, when that call came, that prayer really worked. I don't know how and what happened, but instantly, somebody said, immediately, the chains were broken. Somebody declared, restore. It was only by worship that the walls of Jericho came down. Sometimes you think, how could just singing begin to break the walls down? How could just your singing begin to shake the foundations of walls physically? And cause I was in Jericho and I saw those lines of the walls in this January. Jericho is the first city in the world. Jericho is the limitation, what was stopping them from entering their inheritance. I prophesy to somebody this morning in Jesus, that as you worship, whatever is the hindrance, whatever is the wall, the Bible said the walls of Jericho were securely shut, that nobody can go in and go out. I declare this morning in Jesus' name, that whatever it is that is resisting you, that your heart shall be filled with worship, and the walls will start coming down. In the mighty name.